Good morning and Om Shanti to all of you listeners. Welcome back to your own channel, and to all the new listeners who are coming for the first time, you can have a look at this whole channel and explore different yogasans, flexibility, diet, and even your sleep patterns. It's all mentioned over here in this link. So let's go ahead with 194th day of your godly blessing. And in today's blessing, it's already, everything is very clear. As you go ahead, just listen to it. May you be an intense effort maker, effort towards becoming pure. Until unless the soul is not pure, it cannot go back to God's abode or Paramdham or Brahmalok. No matter how much you try, how much penance you do, how much of shastras or shlokas you remember, or how many different texts you have read on spirituality or everything, until unless the soul is not pure from inside, it cannot go back. It has to again take the rebirth on this earth, again cleanse itself, having done negative karmas, again cleanse the self, and then only it will be able to go back to Paramdham or to God's abode. So, may you be an intense effort maker. So, the effort is towards that. And become an instrument for world benefit with a benevolent attitude and pure and positive intentions. Benevolent attitude towards self and others. Pure and positive intentions towards self and others. So, let's get into the expression part. An intense effort maker is one who has a benevolent attitude and pure and positive intentions towards everyone. We cannot discriminate over here that I don't like this kind of caste, I don't like this kind of religion people, I don't like people from so-and-so state or so-and-so country or so-and-so ethnicity. We cannot be doing all that when we are God's children. That is known as body consciousness. So even though someone may repeatedly try to make you fall, he or she may try to make your mind fluctuate. People can say certain things to us. People can come and challenge us. People can have some form of ego clash with us. Could be jealousy, could be anything. Or could be something which we have done in our previous birth and they're trying to come and take back that revenge. Could be financial, could be physical, could be mental, could be relational. So in any aspect, they might come and disturb us, disturb our state of mind. So what do we do then? Baba says, or may become an obstacle towards moving ahead in your spiritual life, in your financial life, in your health, in your relationships, could be an obstacle, right? So what do we do? Nevertheless, constantly have pure and positive, unshakable intentions towards that one and do not change your feelings because of that situation. That is God's guidance. That is known as Srimad. So that will make us stable in within. So that means the problem becomes smaller. We don't make it a mountain out of a mole and we become bigger. So we become like Hanuman, who used to become larger in his size. So larger in size doesn't mean that you become tall or something. It means your thinking is larger than the problem. You become somebody who is beyond those issues and problems. And you can just jump over the ocean. That is what Hanumanji is being shown as. He jumps over the ocean. That means you jump over the problem. You don't keep on hitting the problem on its head, on your head. You just jump over the problem. You just ignore what the other person is saying, because God has given you respect. God has given me respect. So what other people say, we are in so much of self-respect that what other people say doesn't matter. But at the same time, we don't taunt them. We don't say, you know, certain things which people say, that dogs will keep on barking, but the elephant will keep on moving. So if you call them dogs, even saying those things is very derogatory. So God says that is also not having the good intention. That is also not having the good positive vibration towards them, or having pure and positive unshakable intentions towards them. That's also a negative way of thinking. So God says unshakable intentions towards that one, and do not change your feelings because of that situation. So somebody said something in that situation. See, people are coming with their own sanskars and habits. They have their own insecurities. They have their own bad habits which they have taken along in many births, and you can't expect them to change in one day. You cannot tell them to change in one day. That is something which they have brought about from many births. And in many previous births, from the time Dwapar Yuga and Kali Yuga started, people have been in trouble and turbulations in their mind, in their life, in different life forms. They have been as a mother or a father or a brother or a sister in previous birth, and they have gone through a lot of trouble. So those memories are there within the soul from each birth, and that is the pain which souls are carrying. So what do you expect them to react as? You don't expect them to be jealous. You don't expect them to be hurt. You don't expect them to be sensitive. You don't expect them to be having any form of ego issues Well, they are full of that. So if somebody with that kind of baggage comes and tells you something, you know that very well, that soul is suffering. It's a diseased soul. When anybody is hurt, if you ask them to be nice to you or kind to you, it's asking for too much. So God says all the souls in Kali Yuga are hurt in some way or the other, and you expect souls to be nice to you, kind to you, always loving to you, and always talking nice about you. Sorry, that can't happen because they are carrying that hurt within themselves. So forgive them, let them be, but have good intentions and pure feelings towards them. That's what God wants us to do, and that protects us actually. Let's see how. Baba says, keep your attitude and intentions correct in every situation, and you will not be affected by that situation. If my mind is creating positive thoughts in my mind, whose stage is stable? Whose state of mind is stable? My own. Irrespective of what other people are saying. If they are thinking negative, if they are getting jealous, whose state of mind is going bad? Who's going to have mood swings? Who's going to forget God and think about me all the time or you all the time? They, because they have thought bad about you. So they're thinking negative about you, they cannot forget you. That's what the sin is all about. So if they think pure intentions towards you, automatically they will be able to easily forget you. But if they create impure intentions towards you, thinking negative, it will be difficult for them to take you or me out of their mind. So that is their sin, that peacelessness in their mind, because they've come away from peace, they come away from thinking nice thoughts, and that is what is making them think again and again about you, what they have done bad to you or said bad to you. That is their issue. But your issue should not be that you also start creating the same intentions or same having the same thoughts towards them or complaining about them to others, that see what he said to me or see what she said to me, see their intentions, see what kind of people they are. No. God says don't do that, because that will make you unstable in your mind and you'll be not be able to focus or meditate properly. So God says you will then not see anything wasteful, and your time will be saved in thinking about them or cursing them or thinking impure about them. And after thinking impure, you're trying to make your mind stable by thinking pure of them. So that basketball or tennis match will stop if you think only one pure thought towards them throughout the day, whenever that person comes in your mind. So God says this is the world benefactor stage, because your time will be saved and you'll be able to benefit many people because your own stage is stable, so you'll be able to benefit others with that positivity. So I leave you with this beautiful vadan. If you have any comments, do let me know. You can put something else if you want to add up. And have a blessed day. Stay safe, stay home. Om Shanti.